Assalamu alaikum kids, welcome to the 17th episode from the Seerah stories from the life of our superhero Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hoping you guys have started offering your 5 daily prayers or at least trying to. So now let's find out what happens after the journey of Al-Isra wal-Miraj. After coming back from the miraculous journey of Al-Isra wal-Miraj, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so happy and excited. Just talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the Miraj was the most wonderfully amazing experience for him. He now had the responsibility of telling everyone of all the beautiful things that he had seen and experienced that night. People were a bit confused in the beginning, but as they listened to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, their faith grew stronger and stronger. Those who did not believe him, that is the evil people, were searching for different ways to deny him and to prove that what he was saying was something made up. So they asked him to describe the Aqsa Mosque, and when he successfully described it, they still did not believe. Amongst the people, the one who believed in him immediately was one of his bestest friends ever. Can you guess who that best friend was? It was Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. And all the believers who believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam were now experiencing a great joy to receive the extraordinary gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of the 5 daily prayers. Now kids, after going on the amazing journey of Al-Isra wal-Miraj, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was now geared up and stronger than ever before to face the challenges of his mission of being a prophet of Allah. Now he had more positivity and strength to deal with the non-Muslims of Makkah. During the pilgrimage season in Makkah, people used to set up fairs, as it was a time when Makkah would be filled with travelers from far off countries. It used to be very crowded. There were many different people displaying things to sell, and there would be entertainment. And Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam took this opportunity to explain the visitors about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the religion of Islam. From amongst these visitors, there were a group of 6 people who had come from a place called Medina and were halting at a place called Aqaabah. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to them and greeted them and had a chat with them. He told them all about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and all about the beauty of Islam, and told them that he himself was a prophet of Allah. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam even recited some of the verses of the Quran for them. These people got so impressed by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that right there and then they took the Shahada and embraced Islam. These people from Medina believed from the bottom of their hearts that with the help of this religion, Islam, they would be saved from the disturbances and difficulties that they were having in their communities. They had full hope that this beautiful religion of Islam would end all the fights and evil going on in Medina. So soon after, when these people had finished their business in Mecca, they visited the Kaaba And before returning to their homes, they made a promise to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that they will come back to meet him again the next year during the pilgrimage season in Mecca. When these people returned back to their homes in Medina, they told their relatives and friends about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the beautiful religion of Islam. And many of them accepted Islam and the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam settled in their hearts. The following year, during the pilgrimage season, the six people who had met the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam earlier came along with some other friends of theirs. These Muslims who had come from Medina were so excited and joyful to see Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They had come with good news of the love and the loyalty of the Muslims in Medina. They wanted to know more about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his orders and commandments. Then Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told them all about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's commandments in the Quran. Now these people from Medina promised the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and made a beautiful agreement with him that they will never worship anything other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that they will never steal or fight with one another, that they will not kill any innocent people or backbite and slander anyone, and that they will follow Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in whatever they do. With this, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was very pleased with these people and told them that whoever is going to keep to this promise and follow this beautiful agreement, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give great rewards to those who obey these orders, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared paradise for all the good people. Now kids, since this promise and agreement was made in a place called Aqaabah, so historically, this agreement is known as the first agreement of Aqaabah. So now going further on, these people from Medina requested Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to send someone with them from amongst his people for support and help. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam chose Mus'ab, a companion of his whom he loved very much and who was suitable for this task. Now Mus'ab was a handsome, young, knowledgeable and a very polite man. He was well behaved and was full of patience because he had learned all these nice things from Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Muslims of Medina welcomed Mus'ab with great love and joy, and he began teaching them all about the beautiful religion of Islam. He kept working harder and harder and thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The people in Medina were readily accepting Islam. Although they were a few tough people to handle, but soon after, they accepted Islam as well. Seeing the patience and the beautiful mannerisms of Mus'ab, Mus'ab used to recite to them the beautiful verses of the Quran, and their hearts used to be moved by it. And day by day, so many people were taking the Shahada and becoming Muslims. All these new Muslims of Medina who kept hearing about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam were so desperate to meet him. So during the next pilgrimage season, Mus'ab and around 75 people from Medina set out for Mecca. These people from Medina knew how difficult the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in Mecca, as the people in Mecca were very stubborn to accept the message of Islam easily. And when they met him, they were so happy and they offered him to come and stay with them in Medina. And they took an oath with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that they would protect him and his family just as they would protect their own. They opened up their arms to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and wanted to take him out of this society that did not value him. Hence, the second agreement of Aqaabah was made, that was a promise that the people of Medina would protect the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in any event, even if it were to cost them their lives. Everyone was happy. The Muslims of Medina left from that gathering with total trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now there was only one religion and one prophet for the people of Medina. That was Islam and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. With this, we come to the end of today's episode. Kids, if you're benefiting, please don't forget to press the like button and subscribe to our channel, Zil Nurain. So until I see you next time, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.